Good morning, viewers. Today I am present before you with the character sketch of Satan on the basis of Paradise Lost Book 1. Before I begin the podcast, it is advisable that you use a notebook and a pen so that you can jot down the important points relating to this particular topic. It is further advisable to use earplugs for listening to the podcast. So here I begin. He is the most heroic subject ever chosen for a poem, and the execution is as perfect as the design is lofty. These are the words of Addison. The devil incarnate, Satan, dominates Paradise Lost. He is the most important character of the epic, so much so that his absence will mar the entire essence of the epic. Though the action of the poem turns round man's first disobedience, yet the character who gives epic grandeur to Paradise Lost is that of Satan. He is endowed with some qualities which make him the hero of the epic. According to some critics, Satan, to some extent, expresses Milton's view. He is the most heroic subject ever chosen for a poem, and Milton is completely justified in his portrayal between the two extremes he occupies, the stage in its entire length and depth, and engrosses our attention continuously at high pressure whether he is present or absent. Book 1 introduces Satan. We see him in the moment of his greatest disaster. He is chained and is rolling in the pool of fire in hell. He has dared to fight against the Most High, and the punishment that has been meted out to him is the torment of hell. He has been presented as a fallen creature whose face and form is disfigured, stunned by his defeat and downfall. Milton has presented him in such a way that he appears to be someone of high and gigantic stature. He is a character larger than life. Satan is known to have genius and all its charm, great beauty, great intellect, great emotions, great physical daring, in all things proudly eminent, before his revolt against the Most High. Satan is so determined in his aim that even in his sufferings, his indomitable spirit knows no weakness. The idea of repentance, of begging for forgiveness on bended knees, is loathsome to him. Milton is at pains to point out that Satan's face, which once surpassed the sun in splendor, has now dimmed considerably. Courage never deserts him, and even in the midst of all these sufferings and humiliations, his brain is busy evolving plans for another war. The portrayal of Satan is heroic. As the poem Paradise Lost begins, we find him in hopeless situation with his companions. But the gloomy prospect of the future does not fill Satan with despondency when Beelzebub tells him that their situation is hopeless beyond redemption. Satan replies, whether it is to be weak or miserable, doing or suffering. Satan is determined not to be weak under any circumstances. If one retains his courage and strength of mind, he can make a heaven of hell and a hell of heaven. Satan finds or discovers advantage in hell, and that is, better to reign in hell than serve in heaven. Satan at times appears to be the very embodiment of the Machiavellian ideals of the unscrupulousness. He bids adieu to goodness and determines on the pursuit of the evil done. Satan is a great leader, and courage in him is associated with infinite energy and will to work. Satan is so much determined that to extricate himself from the abject situation, he removes his lieutenant Beelzebub's despondency and gives him new hope. By his infinite courage, indomitable will, and mighty power of action, he organizes the fallen angels, who are shorn of all hope and power, to form a great and formidable army. A real hero is one who not only possesses heroic qualities, but also inspires similar qualities in others. He dominates circumstances instead of being dominated by them. The following lines fit in the character of Satan and prove the fact that Satan had heroic qualities. I quote, "And courage never submit or yield, and what is else not to be overcome?" The picture of Satan, which Milton has painted in the first book of Paradise Lost, is unique for the splendor of its conception and for the master lines of its execution. Milton has portrayed a great champion of freedom who challenges comparison with Prometheus. It is the spirit of liberty that animates Satan. All other traits in his character only radiate from his dominant central passion for liberty. Abercrombie remarks, "Paradise Lost exists for one figure, that is Satan, just as the Iliad exists for Achilles and the Odyssey for Odysseus." Many other critics think that Milton has created the very figure of Puritanism in his Satan, thus unconsciously identifying his consecrated cause with the foul revolt of the devil. It is Satan's character which gives real epic quality to Paradise Lost. Without him, Paradise Lost would be no more than a theological thesis composed in verse. Satan's courage and unconquerable spirit, his vaulting ambition, his fortitude and contempt for suffering, the fierceness of his indomitable passions give to Paradise Lost its permanent value as a work of poetic art. In the character of Satan, Milton has expressed his own pride, invisible temper, love for liberty, defiance of authority, and heroic energy. Satan is a study of obdurate pride. He is made a mixed character with evil passions in which good still lingers. In the beginning, he is selfish, but with abrupt touches of unselfishness. He brings war into heaven and despises heaven, yet he loves its beauty. He is God's enemy, yet he allows God's justice. He ruins beauty, but he regrets its loss in himself and admires it in others. To conclude, it can be said that Satan is a mixed character in which there is good but evil predominates, and eventually the evil master the good. He fills the whole space with the grandeur of his stature. He is in fact a classical embodiment of the eternal dictator type. All in all, the portrait of Satan is so flawless and yet so powerful that it strikes one as almost miraculous. I hope this podcast on the character of Satan proves to be of help to each one of you. Please mention your observations and questions in the comment section below. Please do like, share and subscribe to the channel, and don't forget to click on the bell icon for latest update. Thank you for your valuable time. Here's wishing you a great day ahead.